This is a CMOS drum machine that I made. It's called the UM-TSS drum machine because basically all it does is a four and a floor dance beat. I have another video where I explain kind of the clocking system behind it and how it creates that beat. What I've done since then is added a lot more filtering to each of the sounds, and then I actively mix them all. So I'll just run through each one of the items and play with the knobs. Also, I'll just quickly tell you about the case. It's just a cedar box I painted. This is a just a large 8.5 by 11 label that I cut down to the size I need after I printed it off, and then I stuck it on and gave it a couple thin layers of clear coat spray on top of it. Okay, so I'll start off here with the kick. And the kick has a few controls. Here's the pitch. It goes right up into like a zap all the way down to a really low sound. The other control that the kick has is bass. So it just takes off some of the rumble. If you're listening to this on little laptop or computer speakers, you might not hear the difference, but if you have good headphones or nice speakers, you'll hear the difference for sure. The next thing is the snare. And the only control that the snare has is pitch, so I will adjust that now. The next in the list is hi-hats. Hi-hats has a couple of controls. First one is pitch. The other one is open and close. Basically just a high-pass filter that when you turn the filtering up high enough, it shortens the sound and kind of makes it sound more like it's a closed hi-hat instead of open. So you can hear now it's more of clicks, and if I keep going, it'll shut it right off. Okay, just put everything up. Now what I have for this is a clock input at the back here. It would be very easy to add an internal clock if you wanted to do that. I plan to always be using this with other devices, so I didn't even bother adding a clock to it. I did add a divider so I can divide the tempo down. So then if the device that's clocking it is running at a faster rate, I can divide this down and it still be in the right time, just slower. Then the other controls, invert, depending on what I was testing clocking it with. Some of the devices ended up inverting the clocks internally, I think, before using them. So what I ended up doing was just adding this invert, and that way what was happening was the beat was going in between the notes that the other things were playing. So this just gives you a control to adjust the inversion on the clock. And then there's also a reset button for the 40-40 that divides everything up to create the signal. Now that's not this 4040 that's dividing the clock. This is one that divides the clock afterwards to give the timing for each of these. And I explain that all in another video. If you just check through my video list, you'll see that. And right now, it's being clocked from my CMOS synth. Again, this is another video, sound demo, and explanation on how it works. Right now, its sequencer is running. It's sending the clock signal out at the rate you see going here. This thing's picking up. I'm playing the sounds accordingly. I'll just turn up the synth. I have a key pinned down, and you'll hear it play along with it. And like I said, it's being controlled over here, so if I adjust the tempo, you're going to hear the drum machine change tempo 2 perfectly in time with what the synth is playing. If you're looking for the schematic for this, I'll post it in the comments below, and then I also have it on my site, and there's a whole thread about the whole build project also. If you search for simple drum machine or simple two-chip drum machine on electro-music.com, great forum for all kinds of schematics and help with any sort of projects that you're working on.